I was young, at about this time of year, I was working on our family business, and I'd go to my one uncle, because my dad would say, go to your uncle and ask him what you're supposed to do today. And the truth of the matter is, none of them wanted to deal with us. So my one uncle would say, well, go to that place and clean that area up. And then we'd be back there, and we'd see the dust being kicked up by my dad's truck. He'd drive back. And he'd, what are you doing here? Well, Uncle Wayne told us to be back here. I don't want you back here. Like, we're taking directions from three different people. We're getting yelled at then by both because we weren't then doing what we were supposed to be doing when the one uncle told us. Anyway, it was a mess. And I wouldn't have any of it back. I love every second of it. Well, today's readings kind of give us whiplash like that, I think. Because Jesus says, until I come back, all those things that you heard the prophets say, all the things in the commandments, they're not changing. Just because I'm here doesn't mean they're all done. I fulfill those teachings, but they're not from a different God. I'm from the same God. I am the same God who gave you the commandments, who gave you the prophets. It's now no longer obsolete. But then St. Paul says, really? All that stuff from the past is nothing compared to him. And in a way, they're both right. Well, they definitely are both right. They're not clashing. But what Jesus is telling us is that the truth never stops. The truth of the teachings of God never come to an end. Now, they take different forms. Remember, the people of the Old Testament only knew God the Father. That doesn't mean the Son and the Holy Spirit didn't exist as well, but they were only given insight into God the Father. And so they communicated with God the Father through very different ways. They communicated. God the Father says, the way to stay in a relationship with me is the commandments. And they couldn't really keep the commandments. So he sent them prophets and kings and other people to kind of wrangle them in, but they never could do it. And then, as we hear, in the fullness of time, he sent his son. He sent his son to do what the commandments and the prophets could not do, which is keep us in relationship with God the Father. And then we still follow the commandments. We still follow the teachings of the prophets. We read them at Mass. They don't go away. But brothers and sisters, we have recourse to our God right now because of Jesus if we don't follow the commandments, if we're not able to keep these teachings. We can come back to him. They didn't have that before. And what Jesus says is, when he comes back again, we won't need any of it because we will be with him. And so, brothers and sisters, what was taught of old is not to be thrown away. It still is of God. But who we have in Jesus Christ is an immediate mediator to God the Father, something the people of the Old Testament did not have. That is the gift of our faith, brothers and sisters, that we can be reconciled to our God immediately, even when we break the commandments. And so let us take advantage of that gift, brothers and sisters, so that we were reconciled with him in this life and one day with him forever in the next. Please stand.